As the Charles Ng trial finally gets underway.
A break in the Sexies who used pepper spray on logging protesters.
From the East Bay in Oakland, police cadets plan to walk BART riders to
Southern California courtroom today as the trial of accused mass murderer Charles Ng got underway. The 37-year-old Ng allegedly tortured and killed a dozen people in a cabin in the Sierra Nevadas in the 1980s. During opening statements, defense attorneys told jurors it was Ng's friend Leonard Lake that committed the crimes, but the prosecution played graphic videotapes seized at Ng's apartment, including one showing a man who appeared to be cutting cutting away the shirt and bra of a victim, Kathleen Allen. The pictures are very disturbing, to say the least. Prosecutors then described in detail how the victims were murdered.
That they each showed gunshot wounds. That after each of them, the hands were bound behind the back.
Now, the defense in this case is really simple. And that is that Leonard Lake had a motive for murder. And that motive was grounded in a deep-seated hatred of women.
Leonard Lake committed suicide while in police custody. And with the start of the trial, family members of the victims are speaking out tonight. You'll hear from them on Eyewitness News at 6:30.
Some of the images shown in court today are quite disturbing. Ng's trial began today in Orange County with prosecutors playing a videotape of Ng apparently cutting off the blouse of one of the 12 alleged victims. Prosecutors then went on to describe the way the victims were killed, while the defense placed the blame on Ng's accomplice, Leonard Lake.
That they each showed gunshot wounds. That after each of them, the hands were bound behind the back.
Now, the defense in this case is really simple. And that is that Leonard Lake had a motive for murder. And that motive was grounded in a deep-seated hatred of women.
Lake committed suicide when he was captured in 1985. Ng fled and was later caught in Canada. Ng maintains he's innocent.
For those who knew the victims of the alleged killers, the trail marks the beginning of the end. Roz Plater joins us from the newsroom with that part of the story. Roz?
Well, Mac, as this trial starts, the victims' friends and families are hoping for two things: to get their questions answered and to get some closure.
Harvey Dubs, his wife Deborah, and their young son Sean disappeared from their San Francisco home July 25, 1984. Victims of what prosecutors say was a sexual thrill-killing spree. Dubs was a graphic artist and editor at Video West, an independent production company. Friend and co-worker Lee Callister was to meet Dubs that day. He was shocked to hear what had happened.
You know, someone who was close to me had never been a victim, certainly not in anything as bizarre as this.
Callister believes Dubs may have met his captors and killers through an ad he placed to sell some video equipment.
Harvey was from New York, and I think it's kind of ironic, actually, that he got sucked into this because he was a very careful person. He was paranoid about people.
Authorities say Leonard Lake and Charles Ng are the men responsible for the kidnapping, torture, and murder of 12 victims that horrified the nation in 1984 and 85. Investigators call this estate in Calaveras County the killing fields. Here they found more than 40 pounds of human bone fragments, sheds where victims were allegedly held, and Harvey Dubs' video equipment. Police caught Ng and Lake in June of 1985 allegedly trying to steal from a South San Francisco store. Lake killed himself while in police custody by swallowing a cyanide pill. Ng fled and was captured in Canada. It took 6 years to get him returned to California to stand trial. In another 7 years of delays, Ng has gone through three judges, a change of venue, and 8 attorneys.
I mean, I feel cheated. I feel cheated that Leonard Lake immediately popped a cyanide pill and took the easy way out. And I feel cheated that Ng has run off to Canada. And, you know, like I say, I'm particularly annoyed, angry that he's managed to play the game for so long. You know, and he certainly deserves, if anyone deserves the death penalty, I would think he does.
Now, Ng has always maintained his innocence in this case. Legal experts predict there is bound to be an appeal, so the case could drag out even longer. I'm Roz Plater, live from the newsroom.